A reading from the book of Exodus. The angel of Yahweh, who was going before the Israelite army, moved and took up station behind them. And the pillar of cloud also moved from in front of them to behind them. It came between the armies of Egypt and Israel. And the cloud brought on darkness and early nightfall, so that contact was lost throughout the night. Then when Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, Yahweh drove the sea back by means of an easterly gale all night, turning that part of the sea into dry land, because the waters were divided. The Israelites went through the sea on dry ground, with the waters forming a wall for them on their left and their right. The Egyptians pursued headlong far into the sea, all of them, Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot riders. In the morning watch, Yahweh looked down through the pillar of fire and cloud on the Egyptian army and threw it into a general panic and clogged their chariot wheels so that they rolled sluggishly with great difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for their God is fighting for them against Egypt." Then Yahweh said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea again, so that the water may recoil upon the Egyptians, their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, which at dawn returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians stampeded before it, Yahweh hurled them into the sea. The waters returned and engulfed the Pharaoh's entire army that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them survived, but the Israelites walked on dry land through the sea, with waters forming a wall for them on their right and left. So it was that the Most High saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and all Israel could see the Egyptians dead